Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Stardew Valley and to Dapperdell Farm, where unfortunately we've got a bit of a situation. It is currently Wednesday the 3rd, not Tuesday the 2nd, and that is because of a failed recording. Or at least insofar that the recording had no audio. I noticed part of the way through, right at the beginning of the recording, I was starting up the recording and I sneezed, so I muted the mic and then didn't unmute it. this has happened once or twice to me in the past. And so normally, given that it's, you know, just a humdrum of doing the farm, that would be fine. I'm just like, oh, well, we're a day further ahead. It's no big deal. I'll just go over what I've covered. But two really lovely cutscenes happened in it. So, since I don't want to lose those from the series, but I don't really do the whole post-commentary thing. I'm in the moment when I'm commentating, and trying to do post-commentary, especially over a scene I've already now seen, would feel false. Wouldn't really feel right to me. I'll just add that video into this video. In fact, I'm going to add them in a few moments, just so that you can see what happened, and we'll all be on the same page. So, I will see you again in a few moments. And welcome back. As you can see, they were quite sweet, especially the one with Leah. I wouldn't want to miss that one out. But, right, let's go ahead and check the TV. Mildly perturbed. And the weather, partially cloudy with a light breeze. Very well. Now, we did have a couple of letters. I may actually include the letters in as well, but they were mostly just regular letters. It wasn't really anything too much, though one was from Leah, so I'll probably just keep a little snapshot of that as well. I'm really sorry that got missed out. These things unfortunately do happen from time to time. Now, I'm just going to grab these, and then we'll cover what I did to the farm in the last episode that unfortunately won't be included. I have planted all of our trellis crops. As you can see, there's quite a lot of them. I've also planted all the flowers around the trellis crops, and that's literally just making use of the space, honestly. We've got jazz down here and tulips on the outsides. Those plants I am actually going to harvest. I've also built 3 iridium sprinklers. That's all the iridium we had. And I've popped down a few little places of grass here and there just to make the farm look a little bit nicer, honestly. At this point, that's right. We want to go and let the chickens out and also check on the chickens, say hello to them. And then I will get to the important task of planting some more of our crops. There we go. Come on then, girls. Out you come. Enjoy. Right. Now, I'm going to have to hoe a lot of area here, and then we'll get to planting... I don't know, we can either go for parsnips or the cauliflower. The cauliflower is really going to be a cash crop, so we can start off with that. And then I'll get some high-grade fertilizer for, like, maybe I'll have the parsnips down here and I'll just have the highest-grade fertilizer for that. I think that would be a good idea. So I will bring you back when all of this job is done. Okay, there we go. I have planted literally every seed I have to plant. These are all melons, these are all parsnips, and these are just spring seeds. So we'll see what kind of forage we get from that. Down here, this field is just going to remain fallow until I have sprinklers, because this is already adding, let's see, this is 30... 35, 40, 45, 49 extra tiles worth of watering that I really don't want to have to do, I'll be perfectly honest with you. But thankfully, because of our gold watering can, we can simply stand in the middle here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We just have to water 10 times every day. That isn't going to be that much of a problem, especially for our energy as well. Though our energy is very low right now because of everything we've done. So I think for today, while it's actually getting on, perhaps we should close this down. We're not going to be getting any cows from Marnie today, unfortunately. What we'll do is we'll just quickly water those in the morning tomorrow, and then we can head off to see if we can't pick up some new livestock from Marnie tomorrow, though. Got some trash. We're actually not getting too much trash. We're mostly getting good amounts of actual fish from those pots at the moment. Kasha, if you wouldn't mind. Thank you very much. I know that seems lazy, but it saves a little bit of time. And every little bit of time helps. Right, we want to put the trash in here. Did I get some driftwood as well? Yes, I did. There we go. Not getting anything much out of the driftwood, to be perfectly honest with you. And then we can just drop off any snails and crayfish for use in our various fish recipes. So literally just turning any fish into something, but I could use sashimi for some things. Maybe. I'll have a think about that. The roots planted is still available for me to make. I can't make any fried mushrooms because I need moral mushrooms for that one. Oh well. Oh, actually, I just noticed that I have not got my mayonnaise machines working. There we are. I'll just keep the other one on me for now. There's not really much need for me not to. Let's just drop the mayonnaise in there, and everything else can come with me. We're going to go to the saloon, I think, and just wrap the night up with a couple of drinks with our friends. Many of them becoming more and more friendly with us every day. We're actually doing amazingly well with the progress at the moment in terms of socializing, I would say. We are getting really close to a number of our neighbors. Come in. Everyone else has already left. Oh, hi, Aavak. Sorry if I look a little messy. I've been working in the furnace all morning. That's all right, Clint. No, I don't have time to chat with you. Like usual. Would a burger change your mind? Oh, apparently no. Drat. How about a burger? You know what? Emily, you get a flower. Thank you, I'm feeling a positive energy from this gift. I've heard rumors of rare and powerful magic rings forged long ago by forgotten civilizations. I'm not sure if it's true, or just a fairy tale.
I put stock in it. I could give you a diamond. You know what, Pam? Sure. You're gonna give it to some kid? Thanks. It's not even a love gift. Hey, kid. You're too young to be moping around in a place like this. Some life advice from Pam. That's when you know you've hit rock bottom. Hi there, Aavak. I'm glad to see you. You're always welcome here. Thank you very much. Here you go. Oh, goodness. Are you sure? It's like as good as one of mine. In fact, it's better. Keep it to yourself, Aavak. I spilled a whole bucket of milk on the floor today. It was horrible. And such a waste of my poor Belinda's hard work. Aw, Marnie, it's okay. I'm sure she understands and doesn't hold it against you. Accidents happen. There you go. Oh, maybe not. Clint, have I given you anything today? Yes, I have. Okay, well, fine. How are we doing down here? Only two people in the town have only got one heart with us. That's actually, you know, we're making progress. Slowly but surely. Well, that wasn't really the social call I was hoping for, I must confess, Akasha. I guess we could head home then. That being said, you wait here. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm going to use this magical machine, and I'm going to go and do some stuff. Be right back, Akasha. To the quarry! Aha! This is a good call. Let's not waste our days. We don't know how many of them we're going to have. Anything else? Yeah, some copper. If nothing else, coming to the quarry is useful in terms of just gathering a little bit of extra or using up a little bit of extra time that I have left. I may as well clean it out until I run out of time, honestly. This way, I'm just increasing the odds that we don't waste any of the spawns that the quarry has. Someone in the comments said that you can actually get iridium ore at the quarry. That would genuinely be amazing. Though I imagine it's going to be stupidly rare. So if I can just give the iridium ore the best chance of being able to spawn that I can possibly give it, I consider that time well spent. Alright, let's head back to the bus stop. Thanks for waiting for me, Akasha. Hello, rabbit. Okay. You can go and park yourself over here and have a nice gobble down with some hay and a well-earned rest. 3 iron ore from that. Up to 4 now. That's actually not bad at all. Put half of those in there. Copper ore can go in there as well. And all of the refined quartz, of course. Over here, I'm going to drop these off. Daffodil's coming with me, obviously. We'll keep that with us. I could grab the apples, actually. You know what? Yeah, we'll grab the apples and the pumpkins. We're taking those elsewhere. Drop those off. Oops, got a little bit of extra sap that I hadn't taken account for. Okay, my inventory is kind of better organized. I don't want to really say that because I know a bunch of people are just going to lose their minds over the idea that I think this is well organized. But it's better. It's not good. Better. I think that's fair. Hey, Snufkin. Alright, let me drop off the mushrooms. Oh, I can't fit the pumpkin in there. Nor can I fit the apples in there. Well, drat. That's probably why I didn't put them there then. Oh, well. Ooh, that mushroom should be able to go in there. I really don't actually think that these mushrooms are going to be used in anything. I'm going to take them out. I don't think it's wise to eat those mushrooms. Even if a recipe calls for them. I don't trust myself to be able to prepare those kinds of mushrooms well enough to be eaten. We're going to need some more eggs as well. We've actually got a lot of mayonnaise now. Yeah, I don't think we're going to need to... Why am I always picking up one more than I need? I don't think we're going to need to worry about mayonnaise for recipes for a little while. And we get more mayonnaise every single day, so it's almost silly to have that stored. But I do want at least one in there, just so that if there is a recipe that calls for it, it's available to me when I check. Otherwise, I might not even think to look for mayonnaise. There we are. 2,000. Not bad. Not bad. Cock-a-doodle-doo indeed. Oh, so much wine. Ooh, Kent's birthday. I've probably got enough stuff to make some birthday cake. Oh, birthday cake. By that, of course, I mean some cake. You know what? Let's make some apple wine. Just for the sake of it. There we go. Apple wine it is. I'll just take all of these eggs. I'm probably going to go through them all in the day. Okay, let's check on the television. Ooh, new living off the land. Eel. Eels can be caught from the ocean in the spring and fall during rainy evenings. Okay. We need an eel. The spirits are in good humor today. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. That's not what I wanted to hear. I wanted to hear that it was going to be raining. Raining and storming and pouring. It would have been great, but no. No, of course not. Sure. We'll grab a couple of these. Oh, I still got these mushrooms in my inventory. Wow. I am so oblivious to so many things. Right. Oh, I love it when there's leaves in the air like this. Aavak, flip this letter over for instructions on how to make a super healthy meal. You'll feel energized. Red plate. I'm not in the habit of eating my crockery, Emily. Whether it would make me feel energized or not, I don't think that's a particularly healthy thing to do. Ha ha ha! My beauties have delivered. Thank you very much, bees. Good times. Now, just for the sake of working out how long this will take, let's do this together. So, 21 minutes and 11 seconds on my little... What? Of course, yes. I forgot about this. Oh, okay. It does it in the direction I'm looking. Fair enough. All right, well, that isn't actually going to be that helpful to me right now, but, you know, kind of cool to know. I've completely messed this test up now. I do apologize, everyone. Donk. It's kind of cool. I approve, I think. Doesn't take me long, even when I'm messing it up. Oh, well. Right, so that's all done. Good, good, good. Now we need to, of course, go and check on Snuffakeen. Hello. Good boy. There won't be any mushrooms, because we had mushrooms earlier. Check on the girls. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. Wow, you are very productive today. Okay. Marnie, if you're not in today. Oh, thank goodness. Hey, Marnie. You've been here a while. How's your farm doing? Pretty good, thanks. Take care of the animals is easy as long as you don't forget about them. I would never do such a thing. Why would you even imply it? Who's been talking to you? Miss Penny is teaching me how to write in cursive. Oh, that's awesome. Okay then, Marnie. Purchase animals. We want a dairy cow. I've apparently got to choose a barn. I've got to slowly scroll. Oh, I can use my mouse. Okay. Right, the first cow shall be named Bill. In loving memory of one of the converted Advent soldiers from my XCOM 2 playthrough, who we envisioned, once we left him in the mission, would go off and would have a little slime farm, because, you know, he's an alien. I don't know what he wants to farm. Probably slimes. So, yeah. So Bill shall be our first cow. There you go, Bill. Great. I'll send little Bill to her new home right away. Purchase animals. Excuse me. Choose a barn for your new cow. There we go. This one, Frella. That's actually quite a nice name. Moo Moo Kachu. Oh. You can't fit in Moo Moo Kachu. That is incredibly sad. I'm trying to think of ways that I can make this work, but I don't think there are any. I guess we can sort of do it like this. Moo, moo, Pikachu.
It works, okay? I know the whole point was the moon. Alright, it doesn't work that well, but it's at least close enough. At least I hope so. Right, well, this has already answered something for me, because I know the third name's not going to fit if Moo Moo Kachu did not. But Pissy was going to be Perpetual Cowlick, which is the name of one of the subscribers. It was actually suggested by a different subscriber who just thought the name was just perfect. But it'll just have to be Cowlick, because there's no way I'm going to be able to get Perpetual in there, and there's no way I can consider a shortening of Perpetual that would work. Great, I'll send little Cowlick to her new home right away. Finally. Well, actually, may not be finally. I'm not sure. Does this hold four or six animals? I'll keep going until I can't have it anymore. Tecorado. We will have Blossom. Great, I'll send little Blossom to her new home right away. I want more. More. If I can fit her in there. No, alas, not. Oh, well. It's close enough. We did our best. Alright, thank you. Oh, actually, I will go ahead and I'll purchase the supplies. I'm going to need a milk pail. I'm also going to need another heater. Thank you. Won't need the heater for a while, granted, but we'll have it for now. See if Leah's in. Hey, Leah. Foraging is a speciality of mine. Someday, I'll make you a fresh salad. Oh. I wasn't really intending to use this right away, but no. I had you going there for a second, didn't I, Team Leah? It's not going to be that easy. Or maybe it will. I don't know. She can be incredibly sweet sometimes. Hey, Penny. I wish I could keep a garden, but our yard is such a mess. Maybe I'll live in a place where I can have a garden someday. See, I just feel horrible now. The saloon can get pretty lively at night. Sometimes we even put a coin in the jukebox. Elliot's out and about. That's not too common. Right, can I actually make this garden a little bit better? No. Someone gave me a very good suggestion to try and clean the garden for them, but it doesn't look like I can. Yes, time to warm up. I'm feeling pumped! Good. Would you like a daffodil? Oh, never mind. You would not. Yoink. I like to visit once a week or so to catch up on things anyway. Can I talk to you? No? Oh, okay. Apparently I can't talk to you. Ooh, what? I'm so sick of preparing these samples. I'd much prefer to be building my death laser. Ah! Wow. Oh no! The whole sample is ruined. Harvey's going to kill me. No, he's a doctor. The Ghost of King sees Hippocratic Oath. Aavak, what should I do? Just scoop it off the floor. He won't know the difference. Tell Harvey it was an accident. Tell Harvey it was my fault. No. And be honest with him. Harvey seems like a really chill dude. I think, honestly, I feel you're giving him a bit of a disservice there. I mean, maybe you know him better than me, and he actually is really a cruel taskmaster, but no, I get the impression that he's pretty, you know, chilled out sort of person. All right, I should just tell him the truth. In before he actually fires you, and then I feel horribly bad and marry you out of a sense of debt. What happened? I heard something break. Also, Aavak slurping his tea. I accidentally dropped one of the samples. I'm so sorry. Thanks for telling me the truth, Mara. Don't worry about the sample. We'll just get another one. See?
Thanks for being patient with me, Dr. Harvey. Of course, you've been a big help around here. I don't know what I'd do without you. Aavak, you look a little pale. Are you feeling okay? No, that's actually how I always look. Thanks for making me feel weird. My lord. Can I talk to you? No. Nutrition is important, so make sure to eat well. Try to increase your vegetable intake. I want to move past. Get out of the way. I'm just here for my annual checkup. Don't worry, I'm not I'm not sick. Home cooked meals are best. Do you cook? I do indeed. Harvey, get out of the way! What the dickens? No, I'm not following you in there. I'm not going to talk tomorrow. I plan on spending a lot of time with my telescope this summer. Oh, cool. Daffodils! Oh! Balls! You might want to close that door. I'm not sure what kind of checkup it is. Now I'm wondering more than I would have been if you hadn't mentioned anything, Abigail, but you probably don't want the door open regardless. Oh, goodness, are you sure? Yes, I am. Maybe I'll just get takeout from the saloon. No, you haven't taken out quite frequently at the moment. So you're a farmer, huh? Interesting. How long have we known each other? You've had me around your house. I've literally given you, like, a small treasure room's worth of gifts. And only now you're like, oh, so you're a farmer? That's kind of cool. Wow, Jody. I actually feel a little bit sad inside. I think some part of my soul just died. Thanks. I'm going to sulk. No, actually, I'm not. I'm going to just ride around on Akasha for a little while. Oh, shiny. I mean, it's not shiny, but, you know, shiny. Okay, I feel a little bit better now. The wind flowing through my locks. Hey, Demetrius. How's the farm business going? It's parsnip season, isn't it? That it is, my friend. I can imagine it being pretty peaceful, working outdoors with plants all day. Yeah, I've got a couple of cows now, so it's a little bit less peaceful than it used to be. That was very thoughtful of you. Thanks, Demetrius. Hey, Robin. How's it going? You're always welcome to visit us, even if you aren't shopping, you know? And that is why I bring you gifts. Thanks, this is really nice. You're welcome. However, I am actually fancying looking at some new upgrades. Big coop would be nice. Also, slime hush. This is what I would really like, though, a new silo, just to make sure we've got plenty of... plenty of hay for the animals. Let's go see if Sebastian's around. Nope. I wouldn't have been too surprised if he was still asleep, honestly. It's what, only 3:20 p.m? Ah, those heady days when you still live with your parents and you sleep until 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Then you get up and you don't really do much of anything. Then you go to sleep again. Ah. Those were the best of times. Those were the worst of times. This is a great gift. Thanks. You're welcome, Linus. How are you doing, mate? We haven't talked in ages. People here seem nice, but they avoid me. People are afraid of the unknown. That's true. Maru probably isn't. But she might try to stick you in a tank. Prod you. Try to learn how you work. Hey, Sebastian. I snuck into the caves last night and got a nasty cut from a rock crab. Don't tell anyone, okay? No worries, dude. I'm not going to tell anyone. Here you go. Have a chocolate cake. Thanks. I like this. You're welcome, dude. Don't worry about it. You know, I've been beaten up by rock crabs loads. Nothing to be ashamed of. Well, I mean, maybe. But at least you won't be alone in your shame. Right, I realize it's Kent's birthday. I need to go and give Kent his birthday present. I hope he likes chocolate cake. This is where I find out he's actually deathly allergic to chocolate cake. I've already given you something, haven't I? Whoosh. Oh, there it is.
You're not as boring as most grown-ups. Thanks, Vincent. You get a chocolate cake now, too. Oh, I've already given you two gifts. Kent, you remember my birthday. Thank you. This is great.
Can I talk with you at all? No? Okay.
Haley! For me? Thank you. I've decided I'm going to organize my clothes today. I'll have to throw out all of last year's styles and make room for new ones.
Wow.
I mean, to be fair, you've actually only been wearing this that one outfit the entire time I've known you, so... I guess that isn't as unreasonable a thing as it might have sounded at first. Let's go see what we can grab. Thank you, Akasha. Any more awesome things other than the wiggly worms, of which there are many? Thank you. And over here, just a little bit of coral. You say they are walked the rest of the way, Akasha. I don't like you having to trot between all of these little pools. The rocks are a little bit uneven. Hey there, Elliot. It's a little lonely out here on the beach, so I apologize if I was ever a little too forward with you when we first met. I was just eager to have a friend. Oh my god. That makes me feel so sad on the inside. I've already given you two gifts. Well... For the record, Team Elliot was a lot closer just then than any of the other teams have been. Just the idea of me being so lonely without a friend. Alright, let's go back. No, I'm afraid you're all going to have to wait at least one more episode before I start handing out those bouquets. Right, we've got one stone and one... quartz. Not amazing. Let's drop these off then. How much stone have we got? We're actually not that far off being able to afford... I need the copper, really. But we're not that far off being able to get our next silo. And that's going to be my priority for now. Because I really want to make sure that all of my animals have their food, obviously. Kind of high priority, that one. The wine I can just sell. In fact, I can just sell most of the things that I'm carrying right now. Wine and the mayonnaise and all of the honey. There we go. Everything else would come with me. Oh, we've got loads more stuff. We might actually be in for a bit of a good return with tonight's everything. And we'll use cranberries again, I think. There we go. Drop that off. You can't. I'll just keep you stored for now. Right. Let's go and pop these into the produce bin. Also those into the bar's chest. And we're good for this night, I think. Should also pop the snail in the fridge tomorrow morning. Right, another day done. What have we got coming up? Lewis's birthday. Time to go to sleep. 3 crystal fruit wines made 2,000 on their own. 10 wild honeys made 1,500. 6 mayonnaises made 1,350. And 5 cranberry jellies made 2,325. Yeah. All things told, pretty solid day, actually. My lord. 5th of spring, and we are pretty much filthy rich again. Okay, well, that's a good place to wrap this episode up, I think. Once again, I am so sorry for the bit of an issue with the earlier part of the episode and having to just splice in the cutscenes. I hope you enjoyed them all the same, and I hope you enjoyed the rest of this episode besides. But that is it from me. So until next time we meet, do take care, everyone.